Hey, hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. This is Aseem, and today we are gonna talk about a story that might look like a spy movie script, but that's totally true. We are gonna talk about Operation IronSide, which was recently made into the public domain. It was a joint operation by FBI, Europol and AFP. AFP is the Australian Federal Police. They nabbed around 800 criminals and they seized around 2 tons of cocaine. Let me check that. Yeah, sorry, over 8 tons of cocaine, 22 tons of cannabis and cannabis resin, over 250 firearms and more than $48 million in worldwide currencies and cryptocurrencies. So that's a huge number. And this, a spokesperson from them said that this has been a staggering achievement right now. So I'm going to talk about the story, and this is a very interesting one. So we're going to see how this story unfolds and what are different things that happened, how a human informant, how a source was involved and deeply embedded to distribute these devices, and how these devices eventually led to the capture of these suspected criminals. But that's it, let's start the story. So here on the HACR news, it was published on 8th June. The actual report, it was published on 7th June 2021. So this is a United States District Court order which was unsealed on 7th June 2021, as you can see here. So let's see this story. Fed secretly ran a fake encrypted chat app and busted over 800 criminals. That's something that we already know. So I'll be talking about the story of these encrypted chat apps and how these criminal organizations leverage these to take into their advantage and do their day-to-day operations. So before this, before the current chat app that I'm going to talk about, there used to be a chat app called Phantom Secure. And if we go by the numbers here, so Phantom Secure helped drug traffickers and other criminal networks avoid law enforcement detection through the use of encrypted cell phones. So what used to happen when a criminal was nabbed and they had this Phantom Secure mobile phones, so the whole phone was encrypted, and the FBI or other police agencies, they wouldn't be able to do anything because it had an encryption, and so they couldn't bypass that. And if we go by the numbers, it had over 20,000 users and the revenue was around $80 million in over 10 years. It facilitated, so the charges were facilitation of murder and drug smuggling, because in a lot of these cases, these criminals organized the crime, or they gave contracts through these apps, through these mobile phones that had specifically been built for this Phantom Secure app. So the takedown, they mentioned that over 250 agents were deployed and 25 properties were searched in 3 countries. So what was seized? Around 150 domains, 1,000 phones, and a lot of crypto enterprises were shut down because this disrupted their day-to-day communication. In this, the Phantom Secure chief executive were indicted, and 4 other associates related to them were indicted. If you go by numbers, so Phantom Secure's takedown would look like a blip on the radar compared to this particular operation that they ran this time. So this was dubbed Operation IronSide by the AFP, the Australian Federal Police, Operation Greenlight by Europol, and Operation Trojan Shield by FBI. So if you search either of these names, you would easily find them online. So Operation Trojan Shield, so Trojan Shield is the reference to the Trojan horse, which was gifted by the Greeks to the city of Troy, and that led to the eventual winning of war by them. So that horse, the wooden horse, had soldiers inside of it, and during the night they entered the city and they won the war there. Operation IronSide is a reference to the World War II military deception by the Allies. It was done in 1944, if I remember correctly. So earlier what used to happen, so the modus operandi for government agencies or police agencies used to be that they would try to decrypt the encrypted networks to go into these networks so that they could listen to communications and listen to the chat by these criminal syndicates. But that had a lot of difficulty because every chat was end-to-end encrypted and they had different keys. So keys are the, like, what do you say, you can say passwords kind of thing, or strings, which are used to encrypt the data. So encrypting is like in the plain text, let's say if you say hi Aseem, it would go as a random garbled text of string to the other person, if and the other person on their phone would be able to decrypt it and change it back to hi Aseem. But any other person who is in between, or man in the middle, that's the term for that. So that person won't be able to decrypt that, because they won't have these keys. So that was the issue, and that's why, like, government agencies weren't able to, like, decrypt these encrypted communications, and that's why it was very popular among criminal syndicates. What happened this time? So this time in 2018, the AFP and FBI, they created an Anom app, and there they, like, they somehow infiltrated. It's said that after this phone secure was taken down, they floated their own app, and they lured criminals to come to them instead of the other way around. So that's how, like, there's this thing. So here it's mentioned that the cryptographic barriers were surmounted by inserting master key into Anom's encryption system that was stealthily attached to every message, thus enabling the law enforcement to execute a man-in-the-middle scheme to decrypt and retrieve messages as they were transmitted. So so every encryption system has these keys, and so what they did was they added their own master key into the Anom network, and they made sure that every message had this key attached to it, so that any of these messages, they could decrypt it using their own key. So yeah, they also mentioned that over 20 million messages were captured and read and analyzed. Also, they have mentioned that for devices located outside of the US, an encrypted BCC copy of the messages was forwarded to a server located in an unnamed third country, and from there it was transported to the FBI server, where it was finally decrypted. Encrypted BCC copy, basically BCC stands for blind copy communicated. So the recipient doesn't know that this message has been sent to a third person also. It's a common term. If you have used email, you would have seen this thing there. It said that Anom is the app that was used by these criminal syndicates. So this was a phone, and that phone had it was devoid of any other functionality. It only had this Anom app, and using that app, you can do voice messages, you can do voice calls, secure voice calls, encrypted messages, encrypted text, you can send any files. Basically, it's kind of Telegram or WhatsApp, so you can send any files, you can send any locations, you can. And there were other features, like you could create distribution list, you could verify your contacts through QR code, you could talk to other person without sharing your mobile phones as well, so maybe by a secret code or something, so you don't need to share a mobile phone, so that helped maintain the anonymity there. So if you go to the Anom website, you can see that this domain has been seized. Law enforcement has been monitoring messages and attachments from Anom platform. A number of investigations have been initiated and are ongoing. If you go to the web archive thing, I was not able to see a previous website, like how this looked before 8th June, well, like before 7th June when this was public. So let's talk about how this operation unfolded. So after the Phantom Secure was taken down, FBI recruited a confidential human source. He was he had previously sold phones for both Phantom Secure and Sky Global, two criminal organizations. So he had invested a substantial amount of money into development and of the new encrypted hardware device, which was the Anom device. And this was being sent to a very close group of criminals using this person. So yes, it is also mentioned that besides agreeing to cooperate with law enforcement authorities for the possibility of a reduced prison sentence, the FBI paid the informant $179,508 for the services rendered, as well as for living and travel expenses. So basically, he acted like an agent, and he supplied these mobile phones to all these criminal organizations, the initial ones. The devices organically circulated and grew in popularity among criminals who were confident of the legitimacy of the app, because high profile organized crime figures vouch for its integrity. It's kind of the old school referral system, like, okay, that criminal organization is using that, so it might be secure, and that's why they're using that. And that's how it, like, the word spread, and everyone was trying to get their hands on this, and on mobile phones. It's mentioned that by May 2021, the phones which were procured from the black market had increased to 11,800 in number, of which about 9,000 are in active use, spanning over 300 criminal syndicates operating in more than 100 countries. You can see the map here. So the red parts are where the people with this Anon mobile phones are there, and it spans a lot of these, like it spans almost the whole globe apart from few places. The top 5 countries where Anon devices are currently used are Germany, Netherlands, Spain, Australia and Serbia. Unsealed code documents show with its user base having grown significantly in the aftermath of Sky ECC's eruption. So Sky ECC was another of these spying like encrypted chat mobile phone service. After a takedown of Sky ECC in March 2021, many organized crime networks sought a quick encrypted replacement for a communication platform that would allow them to evade law enforcement detection. This was a deliberate and strategic aspect of OTF Greenlight Trojan Shield, resulting in the migration of some of the criminal Sky ECC customer base to the FBI managed platform Anon. And then they have mention of the international coalition that participated in joint operation. So you can see that this was a huge success, and it was totally like out of the like spy movies. And I won't be surprised if a movie comes up which has inspiration from this attack. Like they could definitely make a movie out of this. So yeah, that's it. I think that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed this session and stay tuned. Have a nice day.